Hello everyone! Recently, I read two books. JR 上野駅公園口 and this English translation, Tokyo Ueno Station. As I am a Japanese, I read this original Japanese version first and later read the English translation. Maybe some of you know this book because it won the American Book Award last year. This is a story about a homeless man Kazu who lives in Ueno Park in Tokyo. He is originally from Fukushima.He came to Tokyo away from his family as a laborer for the construction work for the 1964 Olympics. The main theme of the story is homelessness, but it's not a political book at all. The whole story is like poetry, because Ryumiri-san's narrative is so beautiful. The reason why he became homeless is so complicated. He had his family and he loved his family so much, but sad incidents happened to him. For example,He lost his 21-year-old son, and his wife passed away. Even though he had his daughter and his granddaughter, he felt all alone and isolated. His granddaughter is so nice, cooking breakfast for him every morning. But one day, Kazu decided to leave his home in Fukushima, because he didn't want to be a burden for his granddaughter, who looks after him every day. He had nowhere to go, so came back to Tokyo.And started to live in cardboard box house. It might sound like a very sad story, but I don't think it's just a tragedy, because at the bottom of the sorrow and solitude, I feel pieces of hope and love for the family. At the same time, I feel Fukushima people's patience. Fukushima people went through a lot of disasters like tsunami and nuclear meltdown. They might be the reasons why they are so patient and compassionate.As I read the book in two languages, people often ask me, Hey Yuki, which do you prefer, English version or Japanese version? Well, as a matter of fact, I like both. One of the good points of the original Japanese book is that you can feel the beauty of Fukushima dialect. As Kazu-san's hometown is Minami Soma City in Fukushima, some of the characters are talking in Fukushima dialect, and it's so beautiful and cute.
そして英語翻訳版のいいところは翻訳者のモーガン・ジャイルズさんの後書きが読めるところです。ジャイルズさんは翻訳にあたって実際に福島県の南相馬市を訪れたそうです。その時に地元の人たちがすごく優しくって自然がすごく綺麗で南相馬市が大好きになったって後書きに書いてました。だから私は詩のように綺麗なリュウ・ミリさんの原作小説も大好きだし英語版の美しいトランスレーションも両方とも大好きです。ルーミルさん、ジャイルズさん、素敵な本をありがとうございます。